Happy New Year and hello everyone, I am Kay and you are watching me play Danganronpa today. And well, we just had a talk with Sayaka, I think. And it's a new day. Fantastic morning, isn't it? Taka? Now then, if you'll pardon the interruption. Without waiting for a reply, Taka barged into my room. Okay, dude, that's rude. Just running in like that. What do you want? What's up, Taka? No matter how intensely the stormy seas may batter me, I will not fall as long as my feet are firmly planted. You agree, right? I'm not sure I understand.
Without a doubt.
And if you can't do it alone, just find someone to support you and you can support them back.
You hear me?
That's how you can overcome any storm! I was thinking about it last night and I decided we all need to really come together. And that was when I realized, every morning from now on, after the morning announcement, everyone should have breakfast together.
And
now is the beginning of that fateful day. Please head to the dining hall at your earliest convenience. That's all for now, I have to go let everyone else know the good news. Taka didn't even wait for a reply. He turned and left before I could say a thing. Well, I guess I'd better head to the dining hall. It's not like I have a choice in the matter there. Oh well. Hi. Toko, was it? Toko Fukao. Toko?
What's your problem?
What? Oh, I was just wondering what you were doing here. You should probably head to the dining hall, right? I know. I just need to prepare myself mentally. Prepare herself? What is she talking about? I'm so nervous. What's she so nervous about? Well, I guess we're going to find out. Let's see. Wonder if everyone's here already. I guess they are. Alright, Taka, so what is this?
Listen to me!
Okay, looks like everyone's here, so then let's begin our very first breakfast meeting.
Quiet down and listen!
Everyone, thank you for making time in your busy schedules to come together. What do you mean busy schedules? We are literally trapped in a school, forced to kill each other. I didn't make time for your shit. You dragged me here. I know I already mentioned this earlier, but in order to get out of here, it is essential that we all cooperate with each other. And the first step is this breakfast meeting, to allow us to become friends and build trust. So from now on, let's all meet here in the dining hall every morning after the morning announcement. Now then, let's eat! You want me to eat breakfast with other people? I've never done that before. I'm not sure.
I mean, seriously?
Yeah, it's been a while for me too.
But more important.
Well, anyway, did anyone happen to come up with any clues? Silence echoed throughout the dining hall.
Seriously?
Nothing at all?
Hey!
Anything? It can be about how to get out or who's doing this. Nobody has anything?
Are you okay with this?
You are going to die.
Huh? Do you understand?
If you can't stop yourself from showing weakness in front of others, you will die.
Stop it!
What the hell? Don't even freaking joke about that.
I'm not joking. Adaptability is survivability. Did I not say so? So you'd better hurry up and adapt to your new life here.
What the hell is this?
You're going completely insane.
Adapt to my new life here? Do you have any idea what you're saying?
What?
Yeah, sounds like a girl wants to live here, and hell, more power to her. But shit.
Jesus shit!
No way in hell am I living here. I'm getting out of here. I don't give a shit.
Sure, feel free.
Okay, so nobody has any clues?
What the heck?
One thing I can tell you is who's behind all this. Someone who's totally weird and messed up. Why else would we be trapped in here in the first place?
Hey, listen.
Well, sure, it could be something like that, but for right now, actual clues are... What's up? If
you think in terms of people who are really abnormal or bizarre? Do you think maybe the person responsible for all this could be a certain murderous fiend?
Well, I want to know about that.
What kind of murderous fiend are you talking about?
A murderous fiend?
Chihiro, do you have some idea who might be behind all this? Well, maybe. I mean, I can't really be certain, but...
Got it!
Certainty is not a concern right now. I'll allow whatever remarks you may have.
You know?
Okay, well... If you guys heard of Genocide Jack?
You mean that serial killer that's been in the news and all over the internet? A monstrous villain who's murdered scores of victims in a brutally bizarre fashion. The word bloodlust was left at each murder scene, written in the victim's own blood. Whoever it is, he's like a ghost. He strikes without warning, disappears without a trace. And on the internet, they started calling him... Genocide Jack. That about covers it, I think. They say he's claimed over 1,000 victims. That's just an urban legend though, right? I mean, even like 10 people would be totally insane.
Anyway, whoever Genocide Jack really is, he's obviously some kind of super crazy killer.
And if he really is this ultimate psycho, I wouldn't be surprised if he puts together something like this.
But like I said, I can't be certain. I don't have any evidence or anything. It's just a thought.
Hey, hold on!
But if they're the killer, isn't that like a killer of a problem for us?
Yeah!
It's okay. Everything's absolutely, positively, 100% without a doubt gonna be okay. Well, I would like to have her optimism in a place like this. Because help's gonna be here soon, I'm sure of it. Huh? Help?
Because, I mean...
We've been stuck in here a few days already, right? Nobody's been able to contact us, so I'm sure they're getting worried. I bet they called the police already. Well, if it isn't our teddy bear friend.
What's this?
The police? You're putting your faith in the police?
What are you doing here?
You guys?
You guys? Seriously? Do you understand what role the police exist in now? All they're good for is being a foil, playing against a villain, or anti-hero, or evil organization. Bad guys come along and destroy them, that shows just how badass they really are. You sure you want to rely on such an unreliable group of losers? Come on! If you really, really want to get out of here, all you gotta do is kill.
What the hell?
Why the hell are you laughing?
You know?
I'm just impressed at the total commitment to this whole act.
Come on.
You're still going on about that?
You're fucking dead.
So, Mr. Serial Killer Psycho Freak Bastard, what the hell do you want?
Mr. Serial Killer Psycho Freak Bastard, huh? That's a pretty long name. German, maybe?
As a German myself, I can assure you that is totally a German name. Except we call him Serienmörder Psycho Missgeburt Bastard. Yeah, that's what it is.
Hey, come on.
We know who you really are.
Maybe if I ignore him, he'll just go away.
You son of a bitch!
Hey, don't ignore me, asshole.
Okay, okay. Let's get back to business. Your life here has already begun and a couple days have gone by and nobody's killing anybody. I thought all you kids were lazy and selfish and here you are working together. But I'm totally bored.
There's nothing you can say that'll make us start killing each other.
I got it!
Wait. I think... Yes! Ding ding ding! I figured it out!
In other words...
All the mystery ingredients are here. Right people, right place. So... Why hasn't anyone killed anyone yet? That's what I couldn't understand. I just realized there was one very important piece missing.
What are you...
Sing!
If you want to know, I'll tell you. It's Mauro. It's so simple. I just have to give everyone a motive.
Stop fucking around.
Motive? What the fuck are you talking about?
Hey,
Oh, by the way, there's something I want to show you guys.
You son of a bitch!
Stop changing the goddamn subject!
I have a little video I'd like you all to see.
But
don't worry, it's not some pervy adult video or anything. Seriously, it's nothing like that. If
It's a special video for each of you showing what's going on outside the school.
Outside the school? What are you talking about?
Oh, Esther's so impatient today. Why don't you just watch it and find out? Here in the school, there's a specific place you can go that has everything you need to watch the video.
Good. Then we can go watch the video right now. But before we do that, I'd like to know... What are you? Why did you do something like this? There's something I would like to know, too. Have you been here all this time?
I don't know if I saw you here. You kind of feel like the type who wouldn't be around all the others.
What do you want from us?
What do I want from you? You must know.
That's all.
That sounds lovely. Seriously.
Well, now.
If you want to know more than that, you'll have to figure it out for yourselves. Do whatever you need to uncover the mystery hidden within the school. I won't try and stop you. Just to be honest, it's entertaining as heck watching you get searched so desperately for answers. So I guess I want some amusement from you too.
He's gone. And once again, he left before we could find out anything useful.
Is that right?
Really? I think we learned something very useful. He has no intention of standing in the way of our pursuit of the truth.
Interesting.
However...
Perhaps. But what about the video he mentioned? I'm very curious to see what's on it.
That's true.
Same here. Okay, so... Rhonda started glancing around the dining hall. But when his gaze landed on me, he stopped.
Hell yeah!
Hey, Makoto, check this out for us, would you?
Huh? Why me?
Yo.
Because you're closest to the door. That's the rule, right?
Rule?
Jesus Christ.
Hey!
Piece of shit!
Hey!
Stop fucking around!
You see how passionately I'm begging you? What's the big deal? Just check it out real quick.
Okay. I guess I'll get going then.
Hell yeah!
Awesome. Thanks. I owe you one.
Hey,
if Makoto's going, I'm going with him. It's not safe to walk around this place alone.
Yo.
Yeah, sure thing. We're counting on it, both of you. Anything happens, just yell and I'll come running.
Can't decide if Mondo is totally dependable or completely terrible.
Yeah, I'd have to say he's kind of both.
He's not exactly a bad person, but I definitely can't say he's a good person either. So then, where's the specific place Monokuma mentioned? Must be somewhere you can watch DVDs, but...
Does it have to be DVDs? Seriously, it could be like video cassettes, fucking Betamax, Blu-ray, MP4 files, I don't care.
It doesn't have to be DVDs.
If it's a place to set up to watch DVDs, then...
I have no idea. How to open the map, actually.
Wait, no.
Okay, there it is. That's what I wanted. Map. Helps peak first floor. There it is, AV room. But we can only go to this place. Alright. Wait. This is... Okay, that's the entrance. And this is it. Where else would you be able to watch DVDs or anything? Another monitor or something. What kind of monitor is this? Who would even make this kind of thing? It has Monokuma code written across it. I guess they've covered all the details. Next to the monitor is a high-end DVD player. It should be able to play DVDs. But I don't see any actual discs nearby. DVD players used to play itself. They had something to watch. At least they had to help pass the time. We could watch Lord of the Rings or something. Anyone have Lord of the Rings with them? Probably not.
Huh? There's something inside this cardboard box. It's...
A bunch of DVDs! Each one has a label on it with someone's name.
A
This must be the video for each of us he mentioned.
Hold on a second.
I'd better go tell everyone.
She just ran off. I didn't follow after her. I just stood right there where I was. DVDs in front of me had robbed me of all awareness. I was rooted in place. I think I see something.
You mean inside the box? No?
So you say you think you see something.
A DVD player?
It'll probably play those DVDs, no problem. Maybe I'll just watch mine real quick before everyone else gets here. I sorted through the DVDs I'd found in the box and found the one with my name on it. Then I slid it into the expensive-looking player. I sat down and stared intently at the darkened screen, and then... I yelled out without realizing it, and my heart started racing. Because what I saw on that monitor... It was my family.
You getting picked to attend Hope's Peak Academy is like a dream come true. Make sure you do your best.
I'm so proud of you, son. But remember, don't push yourself too hard.
Are you really watching this, Makoto? Good luck, okay?
If it had ended there, that would have been fine. A message of love and support. After leaving my family behind to attend Hope's Peak, it would have given me hope, given me strength. If this was a normal school, I would have been happy if a little embarrassed. With my family's support to rely on, I would have been motivated to do even better. But here, now it was totally different. I wasn't living an ordinary school life. I had a pretty strong feeling that the video wasn't going to end there. I hated having that feeling, but it turned out I was absolutely right.
Holy shit, someone tore up the place real good.
This time, I couldn't even make a sound. My voice just died. Where did everyone go? It looks like a war zone or something. As if in reply, a voice came floating out of the speakers. I recognized the voice, of course. It was him.
Makoto Naegu, accepted into Hope Peak Academy. Who supported such a lucky boy. But it seems like something happened to this family's well-being. Oh boy, this is bad. What could have possibly happened to this family's well-being?
You piece of fucking shit.
Look for the answer after graduation. What is this? What happened to everyone? I started trembling. I could feel the fear and anger building up inside me like hot metal. God damn it! I slammed my fist against the desk over and over again. A single thought was racing through my mind. What else? How could I think about anything else? I have to get out of here. I have to get out right now. I need to make sure everyone's safe. Makoto? What happened? Make sure who's safe? I noticed everyone standing around the entrance to the AV room. They stared at me, faces full of confusion. What's going on? Without a word, I pointed to the cardboard box.
Is it?
Is that what Monokuma was talking about?
What does this mean?
What's on them?
They all gathered around the box and each of them grabbed a DVD with their name on it. One by one, they each rushed to a monitor. It didn't take long for them to react.
What the
fuck?
This can't be real, right? It has to be fake, right?
Hey, hold on.
Yeah, no way it's real. No way. I can't take it anymore. I can't take this anymore. Let me out of here.
As soon as I saw the reactions, I knew they'd all seen something like what I'd seen. Nobody even bothered trying to hide their fear and confusion. Except for her. Even now, she was totally calm.
I see.
So this is what he meant by motive. He wants to fuel our desire to leave so that we're more likely to start killing each other.
Yeah, indeed.
That is the classic prisoner's dilemma.
Hmm?
Yeah? Let me use an example. Imagine two countries are on the brink of war. But both countries want peace.
as each commits to scaling back their forces as a sign of good faith. But there's a chance that one country may betray the others, so each country fears lowering their guard. The result is that neither scales back their forces, and they both end up betraying each other.
Do you understand?
In other words, the fear of invisible treachery becomes the greatest enemy of stability. It kinda sounds like us right now. Everyone says they work together, but in our hearts, we're all afraid someone might betray us.
Don't put those awful thoughts in our head. That's exactly what they want us to do.
Huh?
I can say that, but maybe you're thinking that once everyone drops their guard, you can just...
What is this?
What?
Hey.
This is exactly what Monokuma or whoever's behind this wants. They want us to fight, don't you see?
Yeah, you're right. We all need to calm down.
So then.
Okay then, maybe we should start by all just talking. Maybe we can just talk about what we saw. That'll help get everything out of our system. Besides, I think we're all super curious, right? I wonder what was in everyone's videos. I'd be lying if I said I wasn't curious. Hey, Sayaka. What was in your video, Sayaka?
What's your problem?
What's wrong? Just hurry up and tell us.
Well, she doesn't look good. You okay there? Sayaka?
I gently placed my hand on her shoulder.
Stop it!
She pushed my hand away and suddenly ran off. Sayaka?
That's enough.
Let her go.
I can't do that. I have to go make sure she's okay. I hate romantic comedies like this. I don't care what happens to her personally.
What?
It's because you're totally faultless. I'm really worried. Then why don't you go do whatever you think you have to? We don't all have to stick around together, right?
I hope you are well.
Speaking of which, I have my own things to take care of. Goodbye. Everyone went their separate ways, but I don't have time to worry about them right now. I have to go find Sayaka.
Well, okay, I'm out of here.
So, where is she? Where could she have gone? She can't have gone far. I should check around the school.
Where else would you check?
Let's check outside and see if she's there.
Let's see, let me just open that huge ass door. See if she's outside. I'm not going to tell you, that's all there is to it. What? I'm not gonna tell you. No way. Hell no. No way in hell.
You're
just acting all nice so we'll tell you what you want to hear. You can't fool me.
What the hell?
Damn it. How the hell did I get footage of that? Okay. Yeah, you've gone a little bit insane. I'm just gonna go ahead and leave you to it. Where's this office? Is she in the bathroom? This is the girl's bathroom. Obviously, I can't go in. I mean, what if this is an emergency? What if Sayaka's in there? I don't care about her enough to follow her to the bathroom. Well, I mean, to be fair, I guess that could mean something else.
But more important.
Hey, Makoto, I'm like super curious what's in everyone's videos. I mean, I can't say I'm not curious. Right? I could totally tell. But does that mean you're gonna tell me what was in yours? Well, it depends what kind of mood I'm in, you know? I don't think she's gonna tell me. Anyway, that's not really important right now. There's absolutely nobody here. Okay, I wonder where she is. I feel like I could check it out on the map. Sayaka run after. Anyway, the video was pretty convincing. I almost thought it was real. But it's fake, right? It's gotta be. I'd like to believe that, but if it was real, do
too, don't think about that. Don't think about what if it was real. Despair Hotel. Where is she? Did she go to her room, maybe? What was in your video, Celeste?
Huh?
Oh, it is you. You really want to know, don't you? That smile, it's strangely scary.
Is that okay?
There are many, many things in this world you're better off not knowing, don't you think? Okay, you're not gonna tell me. You could've just said that. It's my room. Here we have Sayaka as well. Maybe Sayaka's in her room. Sayaka? No answer. I guess I'll have to keep looking. What makes you think she would actually open the door right now? It wasn't your video, Mondo.
What?
Huh? No, it doesn't matter. It's not a big deal. It was fake anyway. It had to be. Whoever's doing all this, just pull it out of his ass.
Stop fucking around.
Yeah, it's gotta be it. Those assholes can't fool me. Very convincing, you're not. And nobody's here, what's this? There's a hedge on the floor. Don't want much, it must be knocked. Well, got me a coin. Alright, where is Sayaka? Probably not in the bathroom. Probably not in one of the locked rooms. She's not here. Maybe in the kitchen? Shit, there she is, and she looks horrible. I found her in one corner of an empty classroom. She was sitting in a chair, hands on her knees, staring absently at the floor. No, she is standing up, and she's got her hands crossed in front of her face. Are you fucking blind? She looked like maybe she was upset, or angry, or no. She didn't have any expression at all. There was nothing in on her face that you could call emotion. It was as if her original mask had been stripped away. Sayaka, are you okay? Yeah, I'm fine. You are the exact opposite of fine. Actually, no. How could I possibly be fine? What did we do to end up like this?
Why did you do such terrible things to us?
What?
Come on out.
Why?
Let me out of here right now.
Sayaka, calm down. As she thrashed around, I grabbed her by the shoulders.
Huh?
I understand how you... I know how you feel right now. When I think what might have happened to my family. But now, more than ever, we have to stay calm. This is exactly what they want. They want us to lose our composure and stop thinking rationally. Think about it. Those videos have to be fake. Because if those things really had happened, people out there would be in an uproar. Our families, the police, everyone. Right? So, let's just calm down, okay? Otherwise, we've already lost. I know I was trying to convince myself just as much as her. I kept repeating those words to myself to clear away the images that had been burned into my brain. Be calm, okay? Just be calm. As long as we work together, I'm sure we can find some way out of here. And help might even come before then.
But what if there isn't a way out? What if help never comes?
If that happens, then I'll get you out of here myself, no matter what it takes. When I said that, I paused. I had no...
Sayaka?
I had no idea what had come over me. I skipped that too fast.
Please, help me.
My voice was small and shaky.
Why is this happening to me? To kill or be killed? I just can't take this anymore.
I'm pretty sure nobody can
Sayaka.
Take this. Finally, she raised her face up from my chest. She looked at me with those big wet eyes of her. Those big, juicy, wet, hot eyes of hers.
Makoto!
Can I believe what you said?
Huh?
That you'll help me get out? No matter what it takes?
Absolutely.
Makoto!
You're the only one I can trust, so please.
No matter what happens, please always be there for me. I need you on my side.
Huh? Of course, I'll be there for you. No matter what, I'm always on your side. I mean, you are my assistant after all.
Makoto.
Thank you, Makoto. Hearing you say that, I feel like I can keep going. Can get through this as long as you're here with me.
Because I'm your assistant.
Like I said, I'm your assistant.
The smile had come now so well returned to her face. It felt a little forced, but still, it was a huge improvement over how she was before.
Hey!
Standing up.
Whoa, hold on. What exactly is standing up here?
Yeah. Makoto, it's standing up.
What is standing up?
Come on!
Do you even have to ask? You're flagpole! Get the hell out of here!
Just a minute!
No, I want to join in! I can fleece him with a bear? No. Also, I'm pretty sure that's not at all what you're talking about. Damn it, if you won't leave, tell us what the hell is up with those videos.
It's about to come out. It's gonna come out like pristine, pure white stuffing. My honest, innocent stuffing is about to come gushing out.
I balled up my fist, took aim, and swung as hard as I could. I had never put so much energy into a single motion before in my life. I leaned back, channeling all my power, and let go with everything I had. Rah!
Are you okay? If I hadn't avoided your punch, you would have just violated school regulations.
Hey! Are you slow?
You could have done with $1,000 gold course dinner in the time it took you to finish your swing. Your speed, agility, alertness, passion, coldness, sense of despair, and organization. It's all lacking.
Well, that was a close one.
What the heck was that just now?
He just wanted to mess with us.
Well, for now, you want to just head back?
Yeah. Monokuma had come along and swiftly destroyed the good mood we just created. Sayaka and I headed back to the dorms. You should get some rest, Sayaka. You still look pretty shaken.
Sorry.
I'm sorry for making you worry about me. You're right. I'm going to lay down for a bit. With a nod and a small bow, she disappeared into her room. Oh, sweet young love. Now on my own, I headed off to tell everyone that Sayaka was okay. Once that was done, I decided to go back to my room. It was hard to think after watching that deranged video. I needed some rest of my own. Jeez, seriously, what's going on here? There's just so many problems. I can't even decide what the biggest problem is. If we are trapped in here? That what I saw in that video might be real? Monokuma? What the mastermind has in store for us? Or are we our biggest problem? I want to get out of here. But I could never kill someone. Do the others all feel the same? Yeah, that's definitely the biggest problem right now. My eyes, they darted immediately to the clock. It's almost 10 o'clock. I fell asleep without even realizing it. Nighttime's about to start. So, how come someone's here? Let's check the door.
Sorry.
Oh, it's Sayaka. I'm really sorry to come by so late. Sayaka? Sayaka, what are you doing out so late? That's when I noticed. My body was trembling. Is everything okay?
It was so strange.
Sorry to bother you, but something really weird just happened. You mean weirder than a talking bear holding us prisoner, wanting us to kill each other? Do you mean weirder than having seen a video? That's supposed to give us a motive to get out of here? A motive to kill each other? Really, is it more weird than this entire situation? Because I feel like it can't be. What is it? Something weird? Just... I feel like that's actually supposed to be her, but it says Makoto's name.
Okay, so... Just a little while ago, I was laying down in my room, and all of a sudden, my door started rattling and shaking.
Her voice sounded like all the air had been squeezed out of her lungs.
Also sounded pretty manly.
I don't know why she sounded like that. Just hearing her talk
I
made me tense
so
up. It was like someone was trying to force the door open. My door was locked, so they couldn't get in, of course, but they started shaking the door harder and harder. I was so scared I couldn't even move. So what happened? After a while it just stopped. I let some time go by, then I got up and opened the door to check outside.
Makoto.
But there was nobody there. There was nobody there. I can speak and read. But there was nobody there. Someone tried to force their way into your room? It shouldn't be that big of a problem. I mean, these locks are supposed to be 100% safe, right? But who would do something like that?
I mean...
It's not like I'm suspicious of anyone here, but still, it makes me nervous. What if something like that happened in the middle of the night? What would I do then?
You don't have to worry about that, right? I mean, we can't go outside during nighttime.
But...
It's just a promise we made, right? If someone decided to break that promise, then why don't you stay in my room tonight? Would that make you feel a little better?
Huh?
What? All it said in the school regulations was that we had to sleep in the dorm rooms, right? It didn't state specifically which room each person had to sleep in, so...
Hey,
But two people sharing one room is... you know... Oh, jeez, I'm sorry. I didn't even think about that. Honestly, that didn't even cross my mind. No, I know. Me either. It's not even that I like the idea, but... if you don't mind, could we maybe switch rooms? Just for tonight?
Well, damn it, there goes your chance of getting some of that sweet, sweet... panic room. Switch rooms?
If it'll help put your mind at ease, then it's totally fine with me. But I don't mind you staying in my room, but are you sure you're okay with me staying in yours? That doesn't, like, concern you? It's fine. I trust you. In that case, then...
it's night time, of course.
Let me guess, it's 10 p.m.
This is a school announcement. It is now 10 p.m. As such, it is officially night time. Soon the doors to the dining hall will be locked. And entry at that point is strictly prohibited. Okay then. Sweet dreams, everyone. Good night. Sleep tight. Don't let the bed bug bite.
Oh man, it's already nighttime.
Okay, so it's settled. I'll head to your room right now.
Oh, if we're gonna trade rooms, we better trade keys too. That's right, we'll have to trade keys.
Again?
Like I said, I'm psychic.
Huh? Aren't you gonna say you were just kidding? What if I wasn't just kidding?
Something resembling a smile had made its way to her face.
Thank goodness. It looks like she's already started to get back to normal. Okay, we'd better trade keys then.
Okay.
Yep, let's do it. We changed keys, and when I looked back up at her again, there was another worried expression there. Makoto, please be careful. If someone comes to the door, don't open it, no matter what.
I won't. The same goes for you, Sayaka. No matter who it is, don't open your door for anyone.
Even if I'm sure it's you, absolutely won't open it. Otherwise, what's the point of even switching?
Oh, by the way, just so you know, my bathroom door tends to get stuck. There's a little trick to opening it. You have to turn the knob, then lift up on the door while you pull it out. Just do that and the door should open, no problem.
Okay, but the showers don't work during night time anyway, right?
Oh, that's right. I totally forgot.
I guess I might use it when I get up in the morning, so thank you.
Okay, well, I better get going. See you tomorrow, Sayaka.
Hey,
Oh, and about what I said before. When I said I was psychic, it really was a joke. Honestly, I'm just very perceptive.
Yeah, I know.
Good night, then. See you in the morning.
Sayaka gave me one last pouting smile and I headed off to my room. I looked around as soon as I got out into the hall. Everyone else's doors were closed. There was no sign of life. Good, there's nobody here. Making sure nobody was around to spot me, I rushed into Sayaka's room. I'm glad she's happy.
So, this is Sayaka's room.
Really doesn't look any different from mine.
It smells nice, though.
Alright. Let's see. If I remember right, all the girls' private bathrooms have locks on them. I'm a little reluctant to go in. Well, that's understandable, I guess. Somebody could call you a perv. Which would actually be right.
It's kind of weird to dig through other people's trash, but I couldn't help taking a quick peek.
There wasn't any doubt about it. It was a DVD with her name on it that we'd found in the AV room.
That reminds me. I never did get a chance to find out what was in her video.
But it's probably best if I wait until she brings it up again. Well... I'm getting sleepy, I guess.
That itself looks exactly the same, but...
I mean, Sayaka still had me looking forward to trying it out for myself. Well, I'll bet you would love to...
care that bad with her, don't you? I won't keep with a toolkit, but Sayaka has a sewing kit, just like the note said. And next to it is the map of the body's vital organs. I don't think Sayaka would like me snooping around too much. I should probably go to bed soon. So I lowered myself onto Sayaka's bed, a pleasant fragrance of velvet. Sayaka's scent. I don't even know. Maybe it'll bring me some sweet dreams. Feeling a little better than before, I fell asleep. Monokuma Theater. Man, and you're all in a big spaceship in the middle of an intergalactic adventure. You've heard of Noah's Ark, right? You're sort of like that. You've set sail and left Earth behind. Now you don't have to worry about crazy neighbors, corrupt cops, drunk drivers, or pipe maniacs. You don't have to worry about the ozone layer or asthma-inducing air pollution. And of course, you don't have to stress about studying for finals or practicing for the big game. But even our divine world of freedom has a few rules. After all, freedom can only exist because of rules. If you're really dead set on returning to that tiny piece of dark poop you call Earth, please do your best to follow the rules. I hope I've made myself perfectly clear.
So then, let's everyone do our best to follow these new guidelines and live happily ever after together!
Hooray! I hate this guy. Well, let's see what the new day brings.
Good morning, everyone! It is now 7 a.m., and nighttime is officially over! Time to rise and shine!
Rise and shine, Mr. Freeman! Rise and shine!
Get ready to greet another beautiful day!
Never going to get used to that, eh? I sat up, still half asleep, and rubbed my eyes. Slowly, I pulled myself out of bed. I remembered I was in Sayaka's room. I just remembered I promised to eat breakfast with everyone else. I'd better get going. I left Sayaka's room and made my way toward the dining hall. Going alone? A few people had already gathered at the dining hall by the time I got there. Hello, Makoto, and good morning. Can you believe it? I was the very first one here this morning.
Good morning.
Hey, Makoto.
Morning.
I suppose I'm early.
I figured everyone who had arrived on time could be considered model high schoolers. The ones who showed up a little late.
Yo.
Sorry.
Sorry I'm late. My makeup just would not cooperate this morning.
Well, hello.
Apologies, ladies and gentlemen. My morning, duty took a little longer than usual. What a time to have a more relaxed sense of time. Most high schoolers fall into this category. And finally, the ones who kept everyone waiting forever.
Indeed.
I suppose I'm late. Good morning, everyone.
My bad,
guys. Slipped right through my alarm.
What's your problem?
God, is it so awful to be late?
Yo!
Didn't oversleep, just so you know. Nope, get lost. I've never been to Bermuda Triangle.
Don't care about time or other people in general. They're the kind to move at their own pace. But regardless, everyone had arrived. Aren't you forgetting someone? At least, that's how it was supposed to go. Wait, aren't we still missing some people? Yeah, Sayaka and Byakuya aren't here yet. I don't know about Byakuya, but I would definitely put Sayaka in the model high schooler category. So, for her to be so late...
What?
What's going on? Did something happen?
Yo!
Hey man, have you seen Sayaka? Why would I have? I just came straight from my room to here.
She forgot about our breakfast promise.
However...
I got the sense she always has her stuff together. Listening to everyone talk like that, a small dark speck of unease rose up inside of me.
back started to grow quickly. I need to go. I have to check on her. The words had barely left my lips before I flew out into the hall. Where I headed first was my room, where I'd let Sandy sleep for a single night, where she was supposed to be safe. And over the course of that one night... Holy shit! We've never completely transformed. What the hell? This looked like a sword I brought back for self-defense. If the sheath would have wrecked the sword itself has been removed. More importantly, where is Sayaka? Oh, the bathroom door is open. Better check the bathroom. Let's take a look inside. And there she is, smiling all over her face. It took me a second to realize that I was screaming. What I saw dug its way through my eyes and buried itself in my brain. And then... everything went black. To survive... deadly life. When I opened my eyes, I found myself staring at a huge ceiling. It was a ceiling I remembered seeing before. When I sat up, I saw someone looking at me. Again, it was someone I'd seen before.
Wait, why did you bring me here?
Ah, you're awake, finally. Are you okay?
Yeah.
Now's no time for sleeping. Get your ass up.
Huh?
You were unconscious, dude. I had to carry you back here.
Well,
it's no surprise considering what happened. What happened? Hey, are you okay? So it wasn't a dream? What I saw? It was real?
That's right. It really did happen. Sayaka is dead.
Deep, dark despair worked its way through my body and then exploded out of me. I shut up and took off running. Hey, where do you think you're going? I have to see myself. To see if Sayaka is... if Sayaka is...
Just give up!
You can check once, twice, a thousand times. Sayaka is completely and irrevocably dead. No, I have to see for myself.
Why?
Listen to us, man. What do you think's gonna happen if you go out there? Well, what good is it gonna do just sitting around here? I mean, why are we all hanging out in the gym at a time like this? Our friend, Sayaka, she's dead. Dead. When I said dead, it finally hit me. I realized she really was gone.
Calm down.
None of us want to be here right now either. Then, why? Can it be obvious? One of... he told us all to come here. Hold on. Don't talk like that. We all protested it. I mean, we remember the terrible price Sayaka had to pay. But...
so...
I'm the one who convinced him to come. Right now, we need to do whatever he says. He has prisons, right? It's not a good idea to defy him without reason.
Correct.
We don't need to make up any more sacrifices than we already have. Why should we listen to anything he has to say? Because he's the one who killed Sayaka.
Wrong!
I would never do that. If you can believe anything, you can believe that. He's here again.
Hey!
Someone violates his own regulation, absolutely will not interfere. You know what? Actually, I'm going to end this episode here. It's gone on for long enough. Sayaka is dead. And well, we're going to find out what happens from here on out. Next time. Until then, check out some of my other videos on my channel. If you want to see more of this, if you want to see what's going to happen next, subscribe, and I'm going to see you next time. Bye-bye.